Assalamualaikum, dear students. Hope you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIEPS Home School. This is Zainul Abidin, Assistant Teacher of Islamic Studies, National Ideal English Version School. Today, I am going to take a class. Islam and moral education for the students of class 3. Today's topic is meaning of hadith. Dear students, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers in the Holy Quran, "Oma yantiku anil hawa in huwa illa wahyu yuha." Actually, the talk or saying Rasul Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is mean Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying and directly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is mentioned Surah An-Najm. Okay, let's start meaning of hadith. Hadith number 1, innamal a'malu bin niyyat. Innamal a'malu bin niyyat. Meaning Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, certainly the success of a war depends on intention. And 2 number hadith, as-salamu qabla al-kalam. As-salamu qabla al-kalam. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, give salam before you speak. Meaning, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, give salam before you speak. 3 number hadith, man samata naja. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he who is silent is saved. 4 number hadith, at-tuhuru shatrul iman. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, purity is the part of faith. That is mean purity is the part of iman. Okay, again I will cross hadith and meaning. Number 1, innamal amalu bin niyyat. Innamal amalu bin niyyat. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, certainly the success of a war depends on intention. That is means everything do you before we have to do intention well. For this, if you do well intention, your everything include into ibadah. Then second, as-salamu qabla al-kalam. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, give salam before you speak. Dear students, when after finishing your class, when you will go your home, we give salam. Your parents, when you will talk, before talking, we will give salam, okay? Every, or when you will see your big brother, we will give salam. As-salamu qabla al-kalam. 3 number hadith, man samata naja. Man samata naja. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, He who is silent is saved. He who is silent is saved. 4 number hadith, at-tuhuru shatrul iman. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, purity is the part of iman. Dear students, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers in the Holy Quran, Surah At-Tawbah, inna Allah yuhibbul mutatahhirin. Allah loves those who purity. So, dear student, we have to purify when you will come in your class. Must be purified. We have to clean because tuhuru shatran iman. Tuhuru, that is means purity is the part of iman. Dear students, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-Hashr, ma ataakum rasul fakhuzuhu wa ma nahakum anhu. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam those take give take those who order take it and prohibited those things we have to avoid it. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the pilgrims Hajj says taraktu fikum amrayn lam tadillu ma tamassaktum bihi ma kitab Allah wa rasulih. I have left here two things, Quran and Sunnah. If you follow this, you cannot be destroyed, you cannot be tadalla, you cannot be ruined. So, I think that Hadith is the second source of Islamic Sharia. So, dear students, we should know Hadith, meaning of Hadith carefully, and we should implement in your activities, everyday activities. Because Hadith is the source of Islamic Sharia, second source of Islamic Sharia. That is all for you. No more today. Dear students, I hope that you have understood today's topics. Keep practicing more at home. Obey your parents. See you again, inshallah.